अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर, आज की इस वीडियो में हम 11th बायोलॉजी चैप्टर 6 बायो एनर्जेटिक्स की एक्सरसाइज के शॉर्ट क्वेश्चन को सॉल्व करेंगे। फर्स्ट शॉर्ट क्वेश्चन इज डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन एक्शन स्पेक्ट्रम एंड एब्जॉर्प्शन स्पेक्ट्रम। ए ग्राफ शोइंग डिफरेंट वेवलेंथ एब्जॉर्ब बाय पिगमेंट इज कॉल्ड एब्जॉर्प्शन स्पेक्ट्रम। इट मेजर्स द एफिशिएंसी ऑफ लाइट एब्जॉर्प्शन बाय पिगमेंट्स। इन कंट्रास्ट द एक्शन स्पेक्ट्रम इज ए ग्राफ that shows how effective different wavelengths of light are in driving a photobiological process such as photosynthesis. The peaks in the action spectrum generally correspond to those in the absorption spectrum of major photosynthetic pigment, indicating that the wavelength most strongly absorbed are also the most effective in promoting photosynthesis. Next is, how is photosynthesis a redox reaction? Photosynthesis is considered a redox reactions, means reduction oxidation reactions, because it involves the transfer of electrons between molecules. During the process, water is oxidized, meaning it loses electrons and hydrogen ions to produce oxygen. At the same time, carbon dioxide is reduced as it gains electrons and hydrogen ions to form glucose. Thus, photosynthesis involves the movement of electron from water to carbon dioxide, with light energy driving this electron transfer. Next is, which molecule contribute oxygen in glucose? Water or carbon dioxide? Carbon dioxide contributes the oxygen atoms that become part of glucose molecule. During photosynthesis, the oxygen gas released into the atmosphere originates from the splitting of water in the light dependent reaction. In contrast, the oxygen atoms incorporated into glucose are deprived from carbon dioxide during the Kelvin cycle through carbon fixation and reduction process. Next is, state the role of carbon dioxide in photosynthesis. Carbon dioxide serves as the source of carbon for synthesizing organic compound, mainly glucose, during photosynthesis. It is fixed into an existing organic molecule, ribulose 1,5-biphosphate in carbon 3 plants, or PEP, means phosphoenol pyruvate in C4 plants, through enzymes catalyzed reaction in Kelvin cycle. The fixed carbon is then reduced using ATP energy and NADPH reducing power produced in the light dependent reactions, forming 3 carbon sugars that later combine to produce glucose and other carbohydrates. Next is, define electron transport chain. The electron transport chain is a series of protein complexes and electron carrier located in the membrane, the inner mitochondrial membrane in the respiration or thylakoid membrane in photosynthesis. It functions to transfer electrons from high energy molecule like NADH or FADH2 through a sequence of carriers releasing energy at each step. This energy is used to pump proton across the membrane, creating a proton gradient that drives the synthesis of ATP through chemiosmosis. Next is, what do you mean by glycolysis? Glycolysis is the first step of cellular respiration, in which one molecule of glucose is broken down into two molecules of pyruvate. This process occurs in the cytoplasm and does not require oxygen. During glycolysis, a small amount of energy is released, producing two molecules of ATP and two molecules of NADH, which are later used in other stages of respiration. Next is, what is the main structural differences between chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B? The main structural difference between chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B lies in the side group attached to the porphyrin ring. Chlorophyll A has a methyl group at carbon 3 position of the ring, and chlorophyll B has a formyl group at the same position. This minor structural difference causes them to absorb light at slightly different wavelength. Next is, how can a cell synthesize ATP through substrate level phosphorylation? A cell synthesizes ATP through substrate level phosphorylation when a high energy phosphate group is directly transferred from a phosphorylated intermediate to ADP, forming ATP. This process occurs without the involvement of the electron transport chain and does not require oxygen. It takes place during glycolysis in the cytoplasm and the Krebs cycle in the mitochondria, where enzymes catalyze the direct transfer of phosphate to ADP to generate ATP. Next is, can pyruvic acid enter Krebs cycle as such? If not, what changes are made to it before Krebs cycle? No, pyruvic acid cannot enter the Krebs cycle directly. Before entering the Krebs cycle, each pyruvic acid molecule is converted into acetyl coenzymes A in a process called oxidative decarboxylation, which occurs in the mitochondrial matrix. Changes that occur, one carbon is removed from pyruvic acid as carbon dioxide. The remaining two carbon fragment is oxidized and NAD plus is reduced to NADH. The resulting acetyl group combines with coenzymes A to form acetyl coenzymes A, which then enter the Krebs cycle. Next is differentiate between C3 and C4 photosynthesis. In C3 photosynthesis, the first stable product formed is a 3-carbon compound, 3-phosphoglyceric acid. The carbon dioxide acceptor is ribulose 1,5-biphosphate, and the enzymes responsible for carbon dioxide fixation is Rubisco. This process occurs only in the mesophyll cells, and photorespiration is relatively high, especially under hot or low carbon dioxide condition. Common examples of C3 plants include wheat, rice, and spinach. In contrast, C4 photosynthesis forms a 4-carbon compound, oxaloacetic acid as the first stable product. The initial carbon dioxide acceptor is phosphoenol pyruvate catalyzed by the enzymes PEP carboxylase. Photosynthesis in C4 plant take place in both mesophyll and bundle sheath cells, and photorespiration is minimal because carbon dioxide is concentrated around Rubisco. Example of C4 plants include maize, sugarcane and sorghum. तो ये थे 11th biology chapter 6 bioenergetics के exercise के short question. Next video में इंशाल्लाह हम chapter 7 structural and computational biology की exercise को solve करेंगे. तब तक के लिए अल्लाह हाफिज़.